Hi, welcome to Genesis Engineers Academy. In this video, I will teach you how to draw an ellipse in our engineering practice by general method. So first I will teach general method, next to that is concentric circles method, next to Oblong method. Okay, so let us get started. First we will know about general method. Construction of an ellipse: when the distance of the focus from the directrix is equal to 50 mm and eccentricity is 2/3. So for that, first we have to draw what is that is directrix AB, that is vertical line, and axis CD, that is horizontal line. So first AB, this is directrix, and you take one point, that is midpoint C. So from C you can draw the axis end is D. Okay, now there is a point called focus. So for the focus distance from the directrix means it is from the C. So what is the distance of the focus F from C? It is 50 mm. So that is given 50 mm. Next, mark point to F, that is CF, is the distance of the focus from the eccentric, that is the directrix. And you have to divide this CF into equal parts. So 50 mm into 5 parts, because you have to divide this into 5 parts, because the eccentricity is 2/3. 2 + 3 is equal to 5. That is why you have to divide that into 5 equal parts. That is the logic. Okay, so 2/3, that means 2 + 3. You have to divide that CF into 5 equal parts. So each part will have 10 mm. Distance. Okay, now so 5 parts are there. Now we have to locate the point V, that is called vertex of that ellipse, that V. Now draw a perpendicular VE from V, that is equal to VF. So the VE is equal to VF. Okay. Now you have to draw a line and extend, that is C and E, joining C and E. Okay. Now you have to draw vertical lines. So before that vertical lines, you have to point these that is equal parts, and you mark them 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so why 8, 9? Sometimes if the distance is more, okay, the space between 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5 must be same. So in order to have the smooth curve, so from these 1, 2, 3, 4 points, you have to draw vertical lines. Okay, so next. So these vertical lines will intersect this CE line. Okay, so this is one point, this is another point, this is another point. So you have to mark right? So like that you have to name these points accordingly. This one, the last point after 9, it will be 10. Okay, so I will take up this 10 temporarily. This will be 10 dash. Okay, now so this 11 dash. Okay, so this 11 dash and 22 dash will become radii for the arcs to be drawn. Okay, so what should we do now? Taking F as center and 11 dash as radius, you have to draw one arc. In the next time, taking F as center, 22 dash is our center. Like that, this is F dash. Why? Because I have not put 2, because that is on the focus. So it will, you need not draw the arc. This intercept itself is an arc. Okay, so next, one more point you have to remember. So this 11 dash, 22 dash, so these are the radii. For the arcs, you have to draw. So taking F as center and changing the radii, you have to cut the arc. That is, you can get the points. Okay, so that is, you can draw. This is the cutting point and this is the cutting point. This is P1 and this is P1 dash. Like that, you have to simultaneously cut the two arcs on 11 dash. Like that, 22 dash on 2 points. So you will have very smooth curve. Okay, so how many parts should we divide? If you clearly observe, see this one. This arc, only one arc will cut the axis. That is the end point. If that is not able to cut this axis, suppose somewhere else here, then you have to draw one more line. You understand my point? Like that, you have to divide these lines into equal parts, keeping a some distance of your known 5 mm, 10 mm, like that. So we have already divided this as 10 mm into 5 parts. The space between these points is 10 mm. You can also keep the same distance, but I have not taken, because here and here the distance is more. So if you are not able to draw the smooth curve, you can also have one more line. Okay, so one more line and keeping that as 0 or 0 dash, like that, whatever it is. Okay, again draw one more point. Okay, na? So that is the most important one. If it is not possible, you can extend some distance, then it will cut. So you have to stop where you are able to cut this axis. So you have 2, that is vertices, and also 2 points only. Okay, if you divide this thing from the same V, if you keep the distance of one V1 as 10 mm, 1, 2, or 1F is 10 mm, or F2 10 mm, but in this figure I didn't follow that one, but you have to follow like that. Okay, so finally you can draw the arc, a smooth arc. First you have to draw a rough arc, and then you have to correct the arcs, that is arc between points, and draw at a stretch a single arc with HB pencil. And all these things, these arcs, all these things has to be drawn with the H pencils and vertical lines, so CE lines, everything. Only one dash, only P1, P2, P3 are with HB pencil. So these are all construction works. So these are the constructional curves or lines. Okay. I hope you understood well. Let us go to the next one. That is Ellipse by Concentric Circles method. So in this, the construction of ellipse with the major axis that is 90 mm and minor axis 60 mm. Okay. Now, so 90 mm is diameter, 60 mm is diameter. So first draw major axis AB, minor axis CD. Rough. Okay. Now, taking O as center, radius as 30, you can draw small circle and also 45 as radius for the bigger circle. AB is the major axis, but here this is the minor axis. Okay, so instead of this thing, okay, I can take that one. So you have to, so I have taken this C, D as center, or otherwise you can point out a point O, draw the two circles, draw these lines AB and CD. So next one is you have to divide these circles into 12 parts. So now you have to draw vertical line from 1 and 1 dash and horizontal line. The same method has to be applied for 2, 2 dash, 3, 3 dash, like that, 3 on the same vertical. So 4, 4 dash, 5, 5 dash, you will have these points. Okay. So if you extend this vertical line from 1, 2, 4, 5, you can put the same, that is, you can get these values and draw the ellipse. But one thing has to be taken care, that is having a smooth curve. So adjust the curve. First draw the small curves between points. Then this point will act as one point that we know, that is P1 and this is P2. This is P3, like that, P4, like that, you can also put like that. Okay. So this, from this to this point, you can cut, you can extend this line and you can cut one more arc, same distance. So, okay. So these are symmetric, horizontally symmetric. Next method is oblong method. So you will be asked to draw the ellipse by oblong method, or otherwise concentric circles method, or other by general method. So in this, we now deal with the oblong method. So in oblong method, so you have to draw a rectangle 80 mm length and to 60 mm breadth. So for that, I draw two lines and I complete the rectangle of length 80 and width 60 and join the midpoints of the rectangle so that I can get AB and CD. The corner points will be E, F, G, H. Okay. Now our task is to divide the AO. So divide this AO into number of equal parts, suppose 4. So if you have divided AO into four parts, you have to divide AE also into four parts. If you divide this as a 6 or 5, you also have to divide this thing accordingly. Okay, so for division, you can apply compass method only. Got it? Now, it is, now you can divide this thing, AO, into 4 equal parts and AE into 4 equal parts. You can name as 1, 2, 3, as 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash. Now you have to join C3 dash, C2 dash, C3 dash, and the opposite way D1, D2, D3 and extend. You have to draw a line joining D1 and extend to D and joining and extend like that. Okay, so these intersect points, that is 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash, and after that you can have the same distance, that is you can have here also symmetric. This point is symmetric. Okay, suppose, okay, we will see how it is. Okay, from this I have drawn one horizontal line and this is the distance. So you can have the same distance with, you can put an arc. Here is one more point and here is one more point. Okay, so here is one more point. Okay, right. So these are the first points. So you can, like that, you can also have the same thing. From vertical, you can have the same, this one as this one. Okay, so this one as this one. Like that, this one as this one. So these are the points we get to by vertical lines. So these are the horizontal lines. So you have to draw a smooth curve joining these black spots called points. Okay, so this is how we have derived or drawn this ellipse. Subscribe if not subscribe, and also press the bell button, but don't forget to press the like button. Share among your friends, at least write a comment about the video.